RuPaul asked his queens to bring it to the runway, and across 12 regular seasons, 6 all-star seasons, 4 international seasons, and even a secret celebrity edition, it has indeed been brought. Fans of RuPaul's Drag Race have seen gag-worthy reveals, sickening silhouettes, and some of the best damn fashion you'll see on reality television. We combed through the seasons to find our favorites and asked you for some of your input about yours. Think of this not as a best of the best, fashion is subjective, as is taste, but think about it as a celebration of those looks that we think are truly among the elite tier on RuPaul's Drag Race. And if we missed any, shout them out in the comments and let us know. Some of the looks that first come to mind when I think about like the best or my favorite fashions are the ones that were truly surprising. Maybe we know these queens now to be capable of turning out great looks, but in the moment, their victory was truly surprising. Top of my list in that regard is Jinkx Monsoon's Dia de los Muertos look in season 5. All season long, Jinkx had been dragged by the judges, especially Michelle Visage, for not delivering glamour on the runway. And in a previous week, the RuPaul roast, she had finally delivered the glamour Michelle was looking for. But this look wasn't about that at all. This was fully realized Jinkx. Fun, campy, totally her. And it was so well done that even though it wasn't glamorous, the head judge still had no choice but to stand.
Jinkx Monsoon.
Drag of the dead.
I feel fantastic.
Naomi Smalls is a supermodel queen who delivers supermodel fashions. But her first looks in the first half of season 8 didn't quite deliver at that bar, especially her kimono look during the Madonna runway on the Snatch Game episode. It wasn't until the very next episode, a makeover challenge inspired by the Wizard of Oz, that Naomi truly stood out. She turned herself and her partner into sickening scarecrows, won the challenge, and became the fashion queen Naomi that we now know and love. Like Jinkx Monsoon, Peppermint was a queen read a lot for her runways in season 9. But then, she shut all of her critics up with her Club Kid runway, in which she turned herself into a literal peppermint. Leaning into her namesake was exactly the right move, and her candy-styled look made all of our jaws drop. Because on All Stars, queens come in with elevated budgets, some of the highest quality, but also the highest dollar, garments are featured on that spinoff. Think about Shangela, who certainly spared no expense with her All Stars 3 finale look. The Star is Born star gave us a absolute red carpet moment right there on the Drag Race runway, sunning one of the most gorgeous gowns the show has ever seen. It was a beautiful moment for her, and it made her moment of loss in that finale all the more brutal to watch. Of course, clothes don't always make the All-Stars look. Sometimes less is more, and going more naked helps. Think about Detox in her Future of Drag runway in All-Stars 2. She went with a Fifth Element reference, painting herself all silver and using these white strips of fabric to cover herself. It was one of the most jaw-dropping looks, so futuristic, so sexy, and it didn't even require a skirt.
Detox.
Oh, okay. Oh my God!
One of the best modern runway looks came from All Stars 5, as Shangela's season 2 sister Jujubee turned out one hell of a look for her own finale. She took an image of Buddha that she remembered from growing up and used it as inspiration for what must have been her best look across all 3 of her seasons. The look felt personal, looked gorgeous, and took something that she remembered from growing up and made it truly fashion and truly drag. If the winner of the show were decided based only on that finale look, Jujubee easily could have won the All Stars 5 crown. We got a couple of your suggestions for best looks from queens who were truly known for their fashion prowess on the runway. One such look was Raja's Moneyball look from season 3. This is a great look, and for a lot of people, it's tough to understand why Manila Luzon actually edged her out of that challenge. I loved Manila's personally, but I totally get the confusion. Raja used fake money to turn out a piece of art. It is truly couture, and I think it's one of the best ball looks we've ever seen on Drag Race.
She owns the world.
If I had the dollars.
Very Linda Evangelista.
All the honey's making money.
One of you all's suggestions was for Aquaria's evil twin look in season 10. So sort of infamously, there must have been like a Cro-Magnon or prehistoric look that didn't make the list. They get this long list of suggestions every season of runway themes. Eventually some of them go unused. Clearly prehistoric was unused. Aquaria arguably used the materials best because she made her alter ego look truly evil, genuinely evil. She she looked like she was ready to battle all of the heroes that she could. We actually had one more suggestion, but I want to hold on to that for a second because I want to talk about a selection of the three greatest looks, in my opinion, from all of Drag Race. That look that was suggested was Raja's Marie Antoinette look from season 3. I know, 2 Raja mentions, but if anyone deserves 2 mentions, it's the original true high fashion queen in Raja.
Raja!
Oh! Oh.
It's fashion week.
There's
yes, it is.
Right?
Oh, yes.
Her Moneyball look was an invention that she came up with on the fly. It looked great. But this look represented what her drag looked like with time and money to work on it. Simply put, this was stunning, and it elevated the fashion bar of the show to new heights. Raja was definitely something of a ringer in season 3, and for good reason. She raised the bar. Speaking of raising the bar, Shea Coulee's Love the Skin You're In runway from All Stars 5, what an absolute slay. This came along at a time when we were all wondering, like, could Shea Coulee actually be beaten this season? Would she, should she be beaten for that crown that she actually wound up winning? Her Nubian goddess realness, as she called it, was nothing short of stunning. So immaculately detailed, so well styled. From the moment it walked out, fans were ready to call it one of the greatest looks to ever be seen on Drag Race, and for very good reason. One final top moment, and the last of the video, is Violet Chachki's tartan reveal from the season 7 premiere. Drag Race is no stranger to viral moments, although it's a little rarer for runways to go viral. This may have actually been the first. Violet Chachki comes out in what looks like a cute, fashionable jumpsuit, ready to stomp the runway. We should have known better, we should have expected more, because then as she takes off her belt in one fluid spin, she reveals into a full tartan fantasy. It was an absolute gag, it was a perfect 10, and it was one of the best runway looks in Drag Race history.
Violet Chachki.
Looking smart and tartan.
Getting a reveal.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Oh! Bay City Roller.
And that's our list. Did we forget any of your favorites? Comment down below and let us know. You can also tweet at Xtra at Xtra Magazine, follow us there, and follow us on Instagram at the same handle. If you want more great content, you can go over to xtramagazine.com, where you can find Drag Race recaps, rankings, and analysis galore. Until next time, just remember, Shantae means day.